Okay, 30 and below. So a malaking youth vote. Must remember, my dad has not been around for quite some time. He left public office, I think, before 2004.
Right, but it's a name that everybody remembers.
But he's not been in the limelight. Fine. Right. So most of the young voters, and my people tell me this, when we go around, you handshake and all, there's not much name recognition. Of course, when you hit voters 50 and above, you get the usual refrain, ah, anak ka ba ni Tito? Yun. Anak ka ba ni Vice President? Yun.
A lot of the senatorial candidates who are making it, who are doing very well in the surveys, are children of politicians. You've got Bongrevili, you've got Jingoy Estrada, you've got Pia Cayetano, Rufy Biazon, Joey DeVenecia, etc. How are you different from them? I mean,
well, you just told me, Kanina, you remembered my impassioned speeches against the charter change, against the impeachment, against all that abuse of power. Nung kailangan magsalita, sino nagsalita? Nung kailangan tumayo, sinong tumayo? Nung kailangan lumaban, sinong lumaban?
So you think that that's different from all the other politicians, all the other senatoriables? They didn't do
plus that. The budget reform, which is a plan on how to spend the money of the people. We have to make sure that the budget is transparent, accountable. There should be people participation, and most importantly, the budget should be very, very understandable to the people. You know, my vision is that the budget should be posted on the website, and not just posted the way it's being posted now. May dalawang pumasok sa website, mag-shutdown na yung website. No, there's it should be a real, with a real server and all that, and all the details should be there. And it should be simple to the point that high school students can download it and use it for their social science or political science papers.
There should be real. What good will that do, having the budget online for everybody to see?
Then that will make it very, very democratic. That will make it very, very transparent. That will make people understand it and hopefully give in their inputs. How can you give your inputs on how to on a subject matter that you don't understand?
And they can be more vigilant, probably,
and
with
be more,
the way
more
that
vigilant.
It's
spent. Yeah, and one would be what has been budgeted versus what has been spent. Real time. Dati mahirap sapagkat wala pang technology. But now with technology, you can have real time. What is budgeted and what is spent. Just like what we did during when we researched the expenses of the president on presidential travel, nakita namin ganitong karami yung budgeted, ganitong karami yung nagastos.
Right. Okay.
And all that, I called it from data available, statistics from the Department of Budget and Management.
All right. Well, before we go into the questions from our viewers, I just quickly want to get your thoughts on certain issues and just very quickly go through them. What are your thoughts on the reproductive health bill?
I believe that people should have a choice. I'm against abortion. People should have a choice, an intelligent choice, so that they should be educated on their options. But I believe that people should not be forced to go against their conscience, because ultimately it's a matter of conscience. In the reproductive health bill, there is penal provision. There are penal provisions. That if you don't do this, don't do that, you go to jail, basically. So if you don't do it because your conscience bothers you, you go to jail. So there is that provision that forces people, that might force people to go against their conscience.
What are your thoughts on divorce?
Divorce? Well, we already have an annulment law. So I guess it's pretty much sufficient because people are availing of it already.
No need for a divorce law.
No, that we still have to look into that. That's something in the works.
What are your thoughts on gay and lesbian marriage?
Gay and lesbian marriage. I guess it's a democratic country and people should have freedom of choice.
And marriage, would you support marriage?
If that's really an issue, we'll take a look at that. Right now, I would say the principle of freedom of choice should prevail.
What about taxes?
What about them?
What are your thoughts on taxes? Should we increase tax collection or decrease tax collection from individuals?
Again, tax collection efficiency is only down to 12%. It used to be 18%. So let's just increase the tax collection efficiency first. And then kung hindi talaga kaya after that, then let's talk about increasing taxes. Pero parang ganito, parang what do you call this? A cup full of holes.
Mm-hmm.
So no matter you pour water into it, if you don't plug the holes, water will keep leaking. Let's plug the holes muna.
What about death penalty?
Oh, I voted against it.
Okay. It's a very clear stand on that one. How about on a lighter tone, what are your thoughts on being a father?
It's all right.
It's all right? Nothing life-changing?
It's wonderful. It's a very... very stimulating and very challenging.
Are you close to your son?
Yes.
Okay. Bobby. We've got a lot of questions for you from our friends on Facebook and Twitter. Mark Duenas asks, is it necessary to have another Gingona in the Senate?
I think the voters will answer that.
Okay. Well, but do you think that it's time for another Gingona to be back in the Senate?
Why not? It's not really a matter of name. It's a matter of what the person has fought for, stands for, and what his plans are for the people. That's what matters.
All right. Dara Isla asks, what are your credentials and achievements that make you worthy of being one of our legislators?
Well, again, my battle for budget reform. I'm proud to say that I'm the only one really in the Liberal Party. I don't know in the other parties, but who's really, really very, very specific and focused on budget reform.
All right.
And again, I will always stand for the principles of transparency, accountability, and people participation. Look at my track record. I have fought the good fight. I have paid the price several times for standing up for what is true.
Rob John asks, if elected, how will you spend your pork barrel?
Well, as usual, it will be spent, number one, in accordance with the principles, again, of transparency. So it will be up in the website.
Mm-hmm.
Number two, insufficient detail, mm-hmm. so it can be stand the test of scrutiny. And number three, we will have people participation.
But what would you spend it on?
Yes. We will spend it on the Millennium. My guide will be the Millennium Development Goals,
mm-hmm.
which is eradication of poverty, education for all, elimination of dreaded diseases such as malaria, tuberculosis,
mm-hmm.
Increasing infant mortality, increasing maternal mortality.
Mm-hmm. That's a whole lot. You're probably going to need more than your share of the pork barrel
No.
That.
Your question to say is, where will you spend it? You cannot, at this point in time, you cannot say, I will spend it in barangay here for this purpose X.
Mm.
You have to have a guide, the parameters. Mm. And my parameters are the Millennium Development Goals, of which the Philippines is a signatory.
All right.